Hello everybody, my name is Ever Barbero and today I want to talk about how to scan and send a document using Dropbox. Okay, you may be wondering why I'm doing this video. The reason is that I teach large sections of engineering courses in college, and the students do their homework traditionally on paper. And because the homeworks in engineering have a lot of sketches and equations, it's quite difficult to do directly on a computer. Out of 83 students, I have one student that does it on an iPad, but I cannot ask everybody to do it on iPad. Okay, so then now with the coronavirus situation, I gotta figure out a way to collect the papers online, because we're shutting down the campus and we're gonna go completely online. So I need to get these papers to me to grade, and the way to do it is to scan it and send it. All right, and then I can correct, grade the paper on the computer. No, do not print, so we save trees, and then I send it back to the students. All right, so at least that aspect is gonna be taken care of that way. All right, so for to do that, then I try to use an app on my phone, but all the apps that I downloaded either have ads or I had to pay to remove the ads, and they have some shortcomings one way or another that I didn't like it until I found Dropbox. I mean, I'm not endorsing Dropbox. I was not using Dropbox until now, but the app is very good. For my purpose, it's very good. So what I was looking for, it was an app that is free and no ads, so that way nobody can complain that, oh, I'm forcing them to spend money. Also, I need automatic page edge recognition, which not all apps have, and I cannot be manually adjusting the edges, okay? So that has to be there. Then also, I want automatic high quality scan without user adjustment. Some apps ask the user if he likes the image or not, or wants some adjustment. No, I want something easy. Most important to me is that the app will do directly a multi-page PDF capture. That is, I don't want JPEGs and I don't want multiple files, because 83 multiplied by 5 pages is too much. It's going to be a mess to handle that. And also, I wanted, if possible, and I found in this one, that it's easy to type the file name on the fly. Right there on the app, one can type the file name. And I need the file name to be typed in an organized way, so that what they submit is easy to organize in my computer, because we have many homework exams and many students, and if file names are all different or capricious, then how am I going to find the homework for a particular student? And then, if possible, and I found in this one, to be able to send and share the file on the fly, which can be done. And as a bonus, cloud storage, because that way the file is saved on their account, on the cloud, and if they lose a paper copy, they still have the scanned document. So that was good. So to do that, I'm gonna demonstrate with my old iPhone. This is a 6S, it's an old iPhone, but it has a very good camera. Quality of the camera is important for the quality of the paper. Okay, I've seen that some phones are not very good, and so I recommend that you should get a good phone. But this phone is like 4 years old and it's superb, so it's very cheap to get a good phone now. All right, so then in order to do the scanning, what we do is we go to Dropbox and we open the app. And when you open the app, then what you see is files. And in files, I have previously added some folders. So I'm going to go to my copy-paste folder. There, copy-paste folder. And I have some stuff there that you can see what I have. Barely, because the camera is not so great. The camera that I'm using to record this video is not so great. So, okay, so then you see that. So when you want to scan this document, all you have to do here in the middle and the bottom, bottom center, is there is a plus sign and it says very tiny create. So you hit that, and then over here there is a menu, and in this menu you pick A scanned document. The second one, even if you don't see clearly, is a scanned document. Okay? A scanned document, now this is a camera, all right? So then you have to move it until the blue rectangle finds a page. And when it finds a page, the app takes a picture. I don't even have to hit the camera button. And then automatically it will resize it to the size, 8.5 by 11. Black and white is beautiful. You can see it's very nice, very similar to the original. All right, and then, okay, I'm happy with that, but don't hit next because we're going to put more pages. To add more pages, there is a plus sign here, which is add page, and you hit on that, and there it goes to the next page. Oops, I forgot about this. So you go there, put the blue line around the page, it will do it itself, yes? And that's it, it's done. See how easy, it's fast. Okay, and the page looks good, and then we say, I want more. Okay, but now I know I gotta do this. Okay, one more. And add page, find it. Okay. And then like that, even though my laptop is there in the way and everything, it finds the page very well. And that's it, I'm done with the scanning. So here on the top right, it says next, I go next. Now very important for me is the file name. I'm very picky about file name, because I have to organize the file. So what I do is I click on it, I touch it, and then I delete it. Okay, I delete it, right? And then I put the WVU ID, which identify the students, and then I put the homework. WID homework, and then what homework is this? It's homework 7, okay, WID, which is unique for each student, and then homework 7, and then I say click here on the top, right, done, and then I'm done, and then I check, okay, the file name is correct. Image quality, I leave it a high quality, large file size, because I care about quality, not about file size. We have hard drives, it's not a problem, we have room, terabytes of room. So. And then, okay, I'm happy with everything, and then I click save. All right, and then it's saving the PDF. Okay, so the R6S is not so fast. All right, so there you go, so it's here. And now it's uploading, yes, and I'm at home, so the network is not so fast, but there it is, it's uploaded already, okay? So now you cannot see because the resolution, but there are three dots, which in the modern jargon means more. And so if I could touch the more, then this menu appears. And here the second one is share. That's what you want to use. Okay. So then you click on share. And here there are two options, links or email. I prefer an email. Okay. Link is okay. I get a link. I had to click on the link. So I got some more work to do if I get a link. Not much, but when you have 83 students, you want to minimize the mouse click. So email is best. So put the email there. To whom are we going to send? I'm going to send to myself. E-B, there you go, E-Barbero, that's right. That's my email. Then you say share, sharing the file. It's done. Okay, so how long it took? 5 minutes. And we're done. Okay, so next I'm gonna do a similar video for Android, and thank you very much.